still.
Yeah.
We say that's the mission of the discipleship family. Today we celebrate the fourth Sunday in ordinary time. Ask that you please silence your phone, prepare your heart to celebrate the sacred liturgy. This week's second collection is for St. Vincent Paul. Through the Beatitudes, Jesus shows us God's heavenly reign and calls us to be meek and humble of heart. So, Pastor Father Delfin, please stand.
And the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. Today, the fourth Sunday in ordinary time, we will be hearing the gospel about the Beatitudes. How do we reflect it in our lives? How do we put it into practice? That all of us are asked to open our hearts and minds as we reflect on these Beatitudes that the Lord is giving to each one of us. May it reflect also in our daily lives as a Christian. And so as we prepare to celebrate the mystery of Christ's love, let us all acknowledge our sins and ask the Lord for pardon.
Lord Jesus, came to call a contrite heart. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, who art seated at the right hand of the Father, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And will Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Love everyone in truth of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Let us offer this month for the souls of Ernest Casulan, Edna Suarez Tenron, Paulino Pag, Nelly Pagito, and Anika Roman, as well as for the special intentions of Roman Betlao family and Rupert Gilrose Mateo, and then Thanksgiving to my welcome.
A reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. Seek the Lord, all you humble of the earth, who have observed his law. Seek justice, seek humility. Perhaps you may be sheltered on the day of the Lord's anger. But I will leave as a remnant in your midst a people humble and lowly, who shall take refuge in the name of the Lord, the remnant of Israel. They shall do no wrong and speak no lies, nor shall be found in their mouths a deceitful tongue. They shall pasture and couch their flocks with none to disturb them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Consider your own calling, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. Rather, God chose the foolish of the world to shame the wise, and God chose the weak of the world to shame the strong. And God chose the lowly and despised of the world, those who count for nothing, to reduce to nothing those who are something, so that no human being might boast before God. It is due to him that you are in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, as well as righteousness, sanctification, and redemption, so that, as it is written, whoever boasts should boast in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
So we hear in today's gospel, Jesus went up to the mountain and began to teach the people the Greek word makarios, means happiness. And so the Beatitudes are ways that Jesus tells us how we can be happy. The word blessed is a reflection of that happiness. This is really what all God wants us to do in life, is to be happy. But, you know, not the happiness that maybe the world thinks of how it would define what happiness is. Now, 3 weeks ago, we hear about this incident in Memphis, Tennessee, about a suspected reckless driving stop there. And unfortunately, that whole incident ended up in a violent arrest. Subsequently, 3 days later, the man that was arrested died. Of course, the past few days, video of that incident has now been released. You know, everybody sees what has happened in that video. Even though the attitude is about happiness, about being happy in this situation, it's by no means a reflection of it. But the Beatitude in a way, also speaks to this tragedy. In each of the Beatitudes, there's a choice that's made, an action that is taken. And the choice and action in each one of the situations in the Beatitude is a reflection of looking at God in every situation. In time of sorrow, seek God. In time of confrontation and tension, seek God. In times of trial, seek God. And by tuning in to the words and the actions and the lives towards God, we are blessed because we encounter God in each of these. Where a poor in spirit does not mean having no money or no finances, but what it means is to have total trust in God. We are poor in spirit when we have to rely on Him to guide us, especially when we don't do the right things, and we need Him to give us the grace and the mercy for His help to be forgiven. This is especially admitted that we have done wrong and that we are in need of His grace and mercy. This also means that we admit that we absolutely can do nothing without Him, and that everything that we have and everything that we do comes from Him. Mourning is not a happy thing that most people want to go through, but Jesus said that the mourners are blessed. Blessed are those who are sorry for their sins, and also not just for their sins, but also for the sins of others. When we see or we hear about bad things that happen, it affects us. We mourn for what has happened. We also mourn for those people that are involved. We are blessed because we have been touched by God, and because we are touched by God, we can see through the eyes of God. We are to be meek and gentle. We're willing to change a bad situation to a better one. We look for justice, but not by the use of violence or vengeance or any other means like that. We need to be courageous to make transformation peacefully. We see that in many examples in history, Martin Luther King, Mahatma Gandhi, Nelson Mandela, where they use gentleness and nonviolence as a means to achieve their goals. We'll be blessed when we hunger and we thirst for what is righteous. This means treating others with respect and with dignity and love. And when we do that, we are doing the same to God. Being merciful is difficult, especially in those situations when we have been hurt, and especially when we are badly hurt. And forgiving is even more difficult to do. But we are to need an example. Jesus is ultimately that example, the one that is a loving, forgiving one towards all those people that caused Him to die on the cross, leading Him on that on those journey up to Calvary. Every time that we pray the Our Father, we're reminded that we are to forgive those who have trespassed against us or who had offended us in any way. We cannot be happy or free if we hold on to things against those who have hurt us or have something that happened that have done something to our heart. The pure of heart or the clean of heart means living our lives according to the morals and beliefs and standing up for what is right. It's a reflection of our own faith. The disciple heart is the one who is ready to receive God's grace, love, and mercy. We work for peace. We try to bring comfort and peace and love to those people that are affected. And hopefully we can bring people closer to God and thereby bringing forth the kingdom of God. Jesus is, after all, the Prince of Peace and the source of all peace. We may be persecuted because we're doing the right things. And we may do the right things many times, all the time. But the world doesn't look at what we do, the right things, the same way. So, therefore, because of that, we have to be stronger than those that will believe otherwise. This is the blueprint or the template for finding peace, justice, love, comfort, forgiveness, mercy, and ultimately happiness in this unfortunate tragedy. Happiness lies not in the world, but in the next. May Almighty God have mercy on us and on the whole world. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
His rights, brother.
I believe in one God.
Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, not of the flesh of the Father. There have been all things for me, for us and for our salvation.
Oh,
brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth, he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering, cancelled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his body, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was done, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for me, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of pain. Resurrection We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Given thanks that you have done this, Lord, to be your presence administered to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Byron our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy, especially Bernice Casula, Edna and Suarez Termo, Pauline Pai, Nelly Fabio, and Anita Clore. Welcome then into the light of your praise. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Bernadette, Saint Magdalene of Canossa, and Saint Josephine Baki, and all the saints who have visioned throughout the ages, when we merit to hear his eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory to is yours, forever and ever. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who sent your apostles, peace I give you. My peace I give you. Look not at our sins, but at the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will. O living reign, forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Nourished by these virgin gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, through faith may ever increase, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for some time.
In honor of Our Lady of Lourdes feast day, we will be having a 9-day novena starting Friday, February 3rd to February 11th, led by the Legion of Mary. Please join us in prayer. Join us for Sweetheart Bingo on Saturday, February 11th. Tickets can be purchased next weekend after all masses or at the office. The event committee will be hosting a Mexican fiesta on Saturday, February 25th, after the Vigil Mass. You can purchase your ticket for $15 starting next weekend, after every Mass or in the office. Next weekend, the second collection is for the Black and Indian missions. I now invite the youth minister to come up and speak.
I'm here today to not only invite you all to attend our fundraiser next weekend, but also to explain why we are having this event in the first place. Next month, myself along with 14 other youth members will be attending LA Youth Day. This conference is the biggest of its kind on the West Coast, where thousands of young Catholics join together to worship God, celebrate Mass, hear world-class youth speakers, and grow in our faith. This event is very important to me and my fellow youth members, and we are extremely thankful to everyone who has already supported us and for this community. Attending this event, the St. Bernard's Youth Ministry and my Catholic faith are important to me, not only because I get to bond with others that feel the same way I do, but because I get to do it with family. They aren't just my friends or people on the side that I see every so often because they have the same beliefs as me. They inspire me and encourage me to grow my connection with God. It amazes me how the energy in the room changes and you can feel the presence of God. You can feel the love that others feel for Him in your own heart. Youth ministry is important to me because it is my safe space. Somewhere I feel I can be myself and have no worries in the world. My faith is important to me because it allows me to understand God's message and spread the gospel to others. It is important to me because God has a plan and my faith allows me to put trust in the plan He has for me. Thank you for your consideration and support. We will be selling tickets and accepting donations after Mass. May God bless our youth ministry and our St. Bernardus community.
So my dear sisters and brothers, let us support also our youth for all their activities and events, and thank you once again for all your support. And also for the Feast of the Our Lady of Lourdes, so you are invited to join in this novena. So we'll be having that 9 days. So in honor of Our Lady of Lourdes, please join us, and that will be right. Start with prayer. Please rise for our final prayer. The Lord be with you. And the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our universal celebration ended. Go forth to glorify the Lord with your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed Sunday to all of you.
You too, Father.